Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Today I'll be explaining you about the renewal of engine room crane wire. This is a new wire you can see, and you can see both ends here. So if the strains of these wires are broken, then you need to change with a new wire. So I'll be explaining you how to dismantle the wire and how to assemble it. I will be explaining you in detail. So this is the new wire you can see here. First of all, you remove the limit. This is the limit. When you hoist the hook, it will touch here and stop the crane. So this hook limit should be removed. You can see the locking here. Remove the locking pin, then remove this lever. This lever will be coming between both the wires. So while boxing back, you have to put it in a similar way. You can see that. Then other thing is, the wire is running through the hook. So this is the locking arrangement here. So remove both the bolts and remove the lock. Then you remove this pin here. Once you remove the pin out, then you can remove the cables. Both the cables can be. This pin need to be removed. So you can see that. Just take it out and see the hook. These two pulleys are there. The wire is going one way here, then takes a round and comes here. See the cable arrangement, so that when you are again assembling it, you should be able to do it in a similar manner. You can see there are two pulleys, so the cables are running through the pulley to the other pulley over here. You can see in this. This is what I want to tell you. You have to remove the pin here. So if you see in this picture, there is one pulley here. You have to remove the pin from here, another pin here. So the cable is running all the way like this to the hook. So there is a if you load too much, then you can always get the overload trip, which is attached at the bottom. You can see here. If you see in this mechanism, what we are doing is we are removing the old cables. Once you remove the old cables, then you put the new one. So this is the old cable which is there running on the drums. End of the cable will be hooked into a slot here, which I will be able to tell you. These slots need to be, you can see here in this picture, when you are actually bringing the hook down, this is one more limit here. So as soon as you come to certain level, this cable will touch this and push the limit, and again the crane will stop. This is one of the limits. So you have to remove this rod also, so that you will be able to remove the full cable out. So once you remove the cables, then you can see the slots. I am explaining you in full detail so that you can understand what you really have to do while changing the cables. So if you see here, this is the slot. So you have to put the slot here to the end of the cable and push it at the other end, so that it is in the locked position. Then you have to turn the drum in such a way that all the wires are coming into the slots here neatly. This is very important. So you can see both the slots here in place. Then you can see which I have removed the old one. You can see here. So this slot is very important. Clean the drum nicely and put the new cable in this slot here. Again, see the slot, push it here, then lock it in the sideways, so that it is done in a proper. This is the new cable and this is the old wire. So what actually happens is, you can see here, I have put it in the slot. Once it put in slot, then rotate it till we get the other end. This end should, you can see one hand coming here through the pulley, and other end also through the pulley it's coming. Then you have a U. You can see in this picture, the whole cable is coming through this pulley. So when you're putting more than 4 turns, or then this pulley will give a signal here. That means the electrical signal will come from here when you are pulling this, and it will trip the crane. There is overload mechanism here. That means how the overload mechanism works is, When the wire is pulled up, the hook is attached to the mechanism here. It will trigger the trip so that the crane is overload trip activates. You can see here the cable goes, and you can see two slots here which is attached to this arrangement. So one arrangement is, you can see here, which I was talking about. You can see the other arrangement is this one. This is when your hook is going up, you have to, when it touches here, the crane will stop. So we have got two arrangement. When you are hoisting it up, this will touch here and stop. And while you are lowering the hook, when the cable or the wire, when it comes and touches here, it will stop. So there are two limits here, the one for this one, for the lowering, other one is for the hoisting. Other than that, we have a overload trip here. So when the load is more, then this mechanism attached here, you can see the box here, electrical signal will come from here and trip the engine room crane. So there are limits on port and starboard side, and forward and aft also. So if you have any doubt regarding